Yeah, so just two quick points. The six currently rejection seems a little bit subjective, or on the face, that's a subjective decision.
Two points for you to clarify. Generally, it's accepted that between 7 o'clock in the morning and 11 o'clock at night, hours of operation are not considered to be antisocial hours. So that's why we felt 6:30 was too early, but 7 o'clock wasn't. So it wasn't really an arbitrary thing. There was some thought behind that. And in terms of Heswell, yes, they are operating similar hours there.
Okay, David.
Thanks, Chair. Just a quick one. Would it be unreasonable to ask for a management plan on how they propose to do this with their delivery work on the ground? If they produce the plan, we can then challenge them whether they break it. Because we've done that on occasions in the past over deliveries and over whatever. Maybe it's asking too much, but it just seemed to be a way of reinforcing it. Because if we don't try and enforce something, but tell them they've got to come up with a plan to satisfy us that what they're doing is okay, then that's a way of making sure that they comply with their own plan. Maybe it's not a matter for Curry, maybe it's a matter for environmental health monitoring.
Would you like to comment on that?
Regulatory measures that are in place around health and safety, statutory noise nuisance. There are other measures that can be applied outside of the planning regime if these things do become a real issue. I think in terms of a management plan, I'm not sure that's entirely necessary, because these conditions that we're proposing on the on the agenda do pick up on many of the points that we would expect to be covered in management plan anyway. So I think we'd be replicating much of what we're seeking the applicant to be required to do through the conditions that we're already proposing to impose.
Okay, if there's no further comments, the officer's recommendation is to approve subject to the amended conditions listed. Do we have a move on? Thanks, Chair. Seconder? Okay. We go to the vote. All those in favour? Kelly, can we just start again? All those in favour, please? Those against? Okay, that is carried. Okay, the next item on the agenda is agenda item 16, which is pages 95 to 98.
Thank you, through you, Chair. This application seeks permission for a single-storey rear extension and a two-storey side extension. The house which forms the other half of this pair of semi-detached dwellings has been similarly extended, and so these proposals will balance the dwellings when viewed from the street scene. The first floor extension has a lower ridge height and is stepped back a metre from the principal elevation at first floor and fully accords with policy HS11 and the supplementary planning guidance note on house extensions. A single objection has been received from the property on the other side. Although some light is likely to be lost to a bay window serving a kitchen breakfast room in this property, two further windows provide additional sources of light to this room, and therefore any impact is likely to be minimal and not such that the refusal of the planning permission could be sustained, having regards to similar extensions in the street scene. No petition has been submitted, but the application has been removed from delegation at the request of Councillor Sullivan, as outlined on page 96.
Thank you. We did have this pulled out of delegation by the Royal Councillor, who unfortunately is in hospital. And the other two board members are not available for this evening. But I do believe that.
May I go back and speak?
Did you want to speak? Okay. All right, that's fine. Okay, so. Do any of the committee want to make any comments on this?
Just briefly, Chair, we seem to have overcome the terracing effect and the roof effect and the planning of the front dimension effect.
Thank you, Chair. Just very briefly, my concern is that it's going to be lost possible seats in the next door if you go to see. Well, having said that, I understand there are very similar extensions within that very road, so it's very scant planning grounds, which we would lodge an objection or have objected.
Through you, Chair, it wasn't really an issue of loss of privacy, it was an issue of loss of light into a bay window at the rear elevation. But as I said in my presentation, there are an additional two windows that give light to that room. So on that basis, we didn't feel that we could sustain a reason for refusal.
Just to be clear, from what I understand, the residents are concerned about loss of privacy, whether or not that's presented in the report is the matter. But as I said, it's not sufficient for concern.
Okay, the officer's recommendation is to approve subject to the conditions. Do we have a mover? Thank you. Do you have a seconder? Thank you. Can we go to the vote, please? All those in favour? It's unanimous, that's carried. Thank you. Okay, we can go to agenda item 17, pages 99 to 118, and these are applications decided under delegated powers. Any comments, please?
Just a very brief one, Chairman. On page 113, the last item but one says that permission required. If perhaps you could just very briefly explain the relevance of that statement associated with this particular application.
Thank you, through you, Chair. As members will be aware, from May last year, the government introduced a relaxation in what could be done under permitted development rights, and what we call a ResEx application has to be submitted in terms of prior approval. One of those applications was submitted for development at this site, but actually when we looked at it, it didn't comply with the permitted development rights and actually requires planning permission. So that's what that means. It means if they want to proceed with the development, they will need to put in an application for full planning permission.
Denise?
About the sometimes we didn't award
is an issue with the planning officer as well.
Thank you to the chair. I guess it is important to say that Hampton Square started off its life as a residential square. So residential development in the square is acceptable in principle. We have had a number of applications for flatter development over the last few years, and we do keep an eye on those. There are a number of enforcement issues around Hampton Square as well, in relation to some of these approvals that have been granted, and as I say, we work forward with those enforcement cases. But just to answer your point, we are aware of the issues in Hampton Square, and we are keeping a very careful eye on them.
Page 101, bottom right, car park rear of town, of course, I'm sure the storage container. I'm assuming, or I'm hoping, that this isn't a permanent feature, and that the storage container is in some way linked to the clarification, garage sites. Is that okay? Is this then time limited?
Yes, it's a time limited.
Okay, subject to approving some of the comments that have been made, we have to lift that report. Thank you. Okay, agenda item 18 then. Planning appeals decided between the 1st of July and the 30th of September. These were delegated decisions. I have been made aware of any other urgent business, so